Thank you, Hui Ting. Now one of our presentation are talking about present and future of IBs in Asia. We have seen that in ECM, some of the countries have shown signs of bright spots. But at the same time, regional financial integration has been very active. And in the case of SGX, we have seen its addition of the first Taiwanese clearing member. Yet, we have to ask ourselves, are all these bright spots sustainable in the long run? Because we cannot forget that there are investors out there who are still getting passive after the recent financial crisis. In addition, for the debt capital market, we have seen that there's a growing importance of local currency debt markets. But this does not come without any country-specific risk, than the case of Vietnam. In M&A, we have seen that Malaysia and Indonesia have been performing quite well, seeing a few significant deals in the past few years. But for the case of Japan, its M&A deals dropped as soon as its yen depreciated. So are all the other Asian countries well positioned enough in their currencies to further their M&A deals ahead? All in all, Asia has seen increasing revenues has been having a fall in its revenue in the past 3 years. By the last 3 months, we have seen that local domestic IBs in Asia have seen significant increasing revenues. With that, how do you think Asia will perform in the future? How do you think IBs in Asia will perform in the future? We'd like to end off our presentation with this question in mind and we'll discuss more during Q&A. Thank you for your attention.